My name's Jennifer. I moved in Prague end of February 2017. I was brokenhearted at the time, and I just felt so worthless and hopeless. I felt rejected and so much in pain. And I just thought that moving here in Prague would be the answer to help me in my brokenness. But instead of having the joy of moving to a new place, I just ended up feeling more miserable and depressed. Every time I'm alone, I just always end up crying, and I just can't explain the feeling of being hopeless. I don't have the joy, I don't have the peace, and I just felt so terrible, and I can never tell someone. I was so ashamed to tell someone how I felt at that time. So one day we are in this hill, and I clearly remember hearing this voice telling me that, you know, Jennifer, the best thing to do is to jump off on this hill and pretend it to be an accident. So I somehow agreed in this thought. And as the days goes by, it started to haunt me. Like, my mind will always pop up ideas how to kill myself and somehow make it look like it will be an accident and that suicide. Because the only one that was stopping me at the time is that, what will happen to my mother if I'm already not around? It started to consume me. I felt so miserable and so alone in the dark. Until one service that I have attended in church, after the preaching, Pastor Jan said, if you need a prayer for healing, you can just come in front and we will pray for you. So I have approached this woman, and then I have told her my struggles and my burden. So she told me that that morning she was also drawing a heart, and she also don't know why, and she draws this one. It's a heart, and then there's a rope that is already being untied. So she prayed for me, and then she gave me some advices, and then at that time I was actually felt a sense of relief, and the burden has just completely gone. So days pass by and I'm feeling great again. And then I'm attending this home group, Tuesday home group, and my home group leader is Fiona. And she told me that, you know, Jen, why don't you attend the prayer for deliverance, for healing and deliverance with Cindy and Caroline. And I was honestly reluctant at the time. For me, I don't need that prayers anymore because I'm feeling great already. But somehow I obeyed. So at the first night with Cindy and Caroline, it's also my first time to talk to them, and I'm completely surprised that I was totally honest with them about my struggles, the depression that I have, the sins that I have, my past experiences, and also the suicidal thoughts. And to my surprise, they really show me God's love, and they prayed for me. They guided me from the brokenness that I have, even on my childhood, the experiences that I have, and they prayed for me. It was a completely spiritual warfare. They battled me in prayers. And at that night, I never felt that freedom that I have even since when I became a Christian. I've been a Christian for 11 years and I never felt that complete freedom that I felt at that night. At the darkest moment of my life, of thinking to kill myself, I never thought that God will also position me in the freedom that I never had before. I have peace. I have joy. God is truly faithful. He redeemed me from going down to the pit. God will always surround us with the right people who can always guide us and whom we can always call a family. I am Jennifer Bola, and God delivered me from depression and suicidal thoughts.